miss this, then we'll be able to give them. Okay. Hare Krishna. So today we are having this orientation program for Bhakti Shastri course. So after a long time, we are having this starting this Bhakti Shastri course here in ICC. One batch of Bhakti Shastri was completed long back under the direction of His Guru Sadhguru Prabhu. Again, by the desire of His Guru Narayana Chaitanya Prabhu, the blessings of Vaishnavas, we are able to begin this second batch of Bhakti Shastri at ICC here. So I welcome all the devotees. So to begin with, I'd like to request His Grace Narahari Chaitanya Prabhu to address all of us on the importance of Bhakti Shastri and also the mood in which we can study this Bhakti Shastri, how it helps us in our spiritual life as well as for our service. So, and after that, I'll be giving a presentation. It's a Bhakti Shastri course presentation, a lot of quotes from Srila Prabhupada about the importance of studying Prabhupada books and importance of formal education in ISKCON, Bhakti Shastri, Bhakti Vaibhav, Bhakti Vedanta, all those courses. And at the end, His Grace Karunamurthy Prabhu, who is a senior devotee from Pune, who has joined us in Bangalore. So he'll be telling about the course pattern and all the exact details of the timings, and also the units, what are the units will be covered, and the time frame and all those things, details will be explained by His Grace Karunamurthy Prabhu. So then we can have question answers. If anybody has any questions regarding this, we can answer. So now I'd like to request His Grace Narayana Chaitanya Prabhu to be in the program.
Hare Krishna to everyone. Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakya Lakshomitamena Tasmay Shri Gurave Namah. Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Vatare Srimade Bhakti Vedanta Swami Vinayana Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Prachayani Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Dharani Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shivasadi Bhagavad Bhakti Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare This is always the desire of Srila Prabhupada to bring in very high standards. Right from the beginning, he had all this in his mind. As the movement started growing and more people started having faith in him and his philosophy and his son, so gradually Srila Prabhupada introduced good standards, and it started higher and higher. So the thing is, there are two aspects of education. One is the academic interest, which will lead to generally, maybe they want to earn money, name, position, and things like that. So that's the usual, generally when they take up education. But the means and the end don't match at all. But Krishna conscious movement, the means and the end both are same. So any academic education in ISKCON should ultimately culminate with devotion to Krishna and love of God. So Srila Prabhupada's books and his purports, as he said that, I never wrote these books. So when a devotee asked, Srila Prabhupada, you're reading your own books. Prabhupada said that, I didn't write this. Krishna dictated, so I put it down. So the heart of a pure devotee always reads everything to Krishna. But it's also true that the Paramatma always guides his pure devotee. So in this sense, you're all taking Bhakti Shastri course. My personal recent experience about 2 years back when I joined the GBC college, I was thinking, oh my God, this age we have to do all this. But the end of the course, it was almost 1 year, but it was more of administration and also certain aspects of administration based on the Shastra, based on what Srila Prabhupada's teachings. So when I came out actually as a new person, because certainly it was a distorted progress in spiritual life, maybe of so many years, but direction was correct. So, but understanding was all haphazard. But when I went through this college, really it was an eye-opener, and everything was so systematically put. And the course was very helpful in the administration, as well as so many aspects were taught, caring and relationship, Vaishnava etiquette. Certainly all these elements are vitamins and vital to, especially in leading Krishna ISKCON movement, and also the beautiful relationship with Krishna and the present generation and the future generation. So a very lot of teachers were there coming and giving their expertise in different subject matter. But it was all done within about 30 days of training, personal. We had to be there in the college, but at that time it was online. Some of you were also part of me who were developing that course, this strategic plan. But we have implemented quite a bit in our ISKCON ICC. Suman Bonhari knows about it. We are inching towards further. So any education which will serve humanity, which will bring happiness, which will bring cohesiveness, which will bring love and affection towards society and art, and also it will, which will also help us to understand the soul aspect, not the body first, the soul aspect. And also it will drive towards what Srila Prabhupada talked about, where the whole world can live in it. So the word Srila Prabhupada used, where ISKCON can host everyone in this world, literally means it's the heart. So when Krishna resides in the heart, it becomes Vasudeva Kutumbakam. When each soul sees another soul as a part and parcel of Krishna, that is a relationship, what we all have in common with their lordships. So ultimately, the present world is only 1/4 of the spiritual world, but nevertheless, it's still part of the world, of that world. So we have been here, we're getting trained, and we make progress and go back to the spiritual world. So knowingly, unknowingly, somehow we have landed up. But fortunately, as Lord Chaitanya says, Brahmanda Brahmitekani Bhagyavan Jeeva, Guru Krishna Paya Bhakti Lata Bija. So we've been fortunate to be part of this ISKCON society, which is very sublime, which is very tasty, which is very resourceful, whatnot, everything is available. Because Krishna, you get everything. So in the same way, most of you have been in this part of ISKCON quite some time. And if you are now taking up the Bhakti Shastri course, I'm sure you all see this. But what the way I understand is Bhakti Shastri, it's an educational program, no doubt. But if it does not awaken the pure consciousness and the relationship with Krishna and others, then it will be a futile exercise. So why systematic present? Because most of us are now going to college, trying to learn many things. And the whole, we are in the construction area. That means somebody is expertise in teaching, somebody is building up dams, somebody. So it will contribute to a society. You may be getting paid, but that is natural. So, but when we put our heart in the end result, okay, whatever I've done, it helps the society. That, the satisfaction what you get from that is more than what you earn money. So this is what is Krishna consciousness all about. When you do Bhakti Shastri course, the end of the course should help you to systematically understand and present this to the other person through heart by heart. It is not by chapter wise chapter. No, you understand and you connect with that in such a way that the love for Krishna. Is something wrong?
Is it? No, it's, yeah, please continue.
So it is something which is transmitted heart to heart. In a family of husband, wife, children, and parents, we doubt anybody's doubt integrity of anybody. So we all work towards that house. This is Srila Prabhupada's house. Whole world can live in it. That's his defined. That's where he has defined. So all of us taking up this course should help to build, to reinforce the love we care for each other with Krishna and Guru in center. So certainly all of you are looking forward in understanding how this bhakti fructifies, grows into a big tree, and what it's going to do. A tree means it gives you shade, it gives you fruits, it gives you flower. So all of us are growing. We are supposed to give, not to take. When we start giving, Krishna returns back. So it's a great opportunity. And also we are fortunate that ICC, a month back, we were discussing with Mayapur Academic Institute. They were very happy to accord the status of that we can conduct Bhakti Shastri. We have Karuna Murthy, we have Swarn Gaur Hari Prabhu, we have Swayam Prakash. All these people are experts. And as I see them, they have a heart where bhakti is fructifying. I don't see any element of any anartha in them, and I'm learning from them. So through you, I'll also learn. So best of luck for all of you. I'm sure Krishna has many plans from you. Many more devotees will take up. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, and your spiritual masters also very happy. And certainly the last is, I'll have many pandits in our temple who will make sure many bloom in Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Panchakalpatru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Devcha Pajitanam Bhavani Vyo Vashni Vyo. What goes, Prabhu? Lord is yours.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Prabhu, for giving us your insights of your learning in GBC College and implementing those things here, and also for giving the idea of how we should not just read but also bring it to practice, and also exhibit those qualities which are mentioned in the books, not just theoretically study but also practice it and bring it to life in our own life. So thank you very much, Guruji, for your inspiration, blessings and encouragement.
Hare Krishna. Best of luck to all the students.
Hare Krishna. We have about 35 devotees joining here today.
I saw it. I'm seeing 40.
That's including all four of us.
All right. Okay. Very nice.
Hare Krishna.
All right.
So, now I'll continue with the presentation. There's a PowerPoint which is made by Bhakti Shastri team, which gives us insights into what is the Bhakti Shastri course. So Mayapur Institute. Is the PPT visible?
It's visible.
Oh, okay, thank you. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalaka Chakshurun Mitam Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. So I personally had this fortune of attending this Bhakti Shastri course long back, maybe in 2013-14, when I joined Brahmacharya Ashram in Pune. It's had a very intensive training program. So it was very nice to go through. Although I had read Prabhupada books, I had read all the Nectar of Devotion, Nectar of Instruction, Nectar of Devotion, the first part, Ishopanishad, Bhagavad Gita also we had read one or two times. But going through this course, learning from a teacher helped us very much to appreciate the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. Because what happens when you read some book, we miss out certain points, certain vital points in that book, which we can learn from the teacher. So that's what happened. And there is a kind of study atmosphere created. So many brahmacharis together studying, and also here all congregation devotees studying. Whenever you meet with each other, you discuss about, okay, that chapter, this point we learned from this, and then we have to prepare for the exam. So we keep discussing Shastra a lot, especially during Bhakti Shastri. So Prabhupada says this in this purport, and sometimes we quote Acharyas a little bit, not much, but mostly this is from Prabhupada purports, Bhakti Shastri. So a lot of discussion about Prabhupada books and in-depth study of Prabhupada books happens. So it brings a community together with Prabhupada's books in the center. So that in that sense, unifies the whole community centered around Prabhupada books. So we did that course in 2014. And now we're getting an opportunity to teach by the blessings of Guru and Krishna. So me, Karunamurthy Prabhu, Swami Prakash Prabhu will try our best to share this knowledge with all of you. So here, this is a Mayapur Bhakti Shastri course. So every temple should be educational center. Okay. So Prabhupada writes here, Brahmanas means that they are teachers. So every temple should be an educational center and the Brahmanas should be engaged. They should be properly educated and they should teach others also. In this way, temple means education in spiritual life. Conversation, August 22, 1976. So Prabhupada is telling the temple, generally Vedic version of temple, what we see, not Vedic version, but current version of temple is you go, ring the bell, put some dakshina, sit for 2 minutes and come out. But Prabhupada didn't want ISKCON temples to be like that. He wanted them to be educational centers. Like we have named our temple ISKCON cultural center because here is where the culture of Krishna will be taught, educated. So the dream of our temple is to have so many courses for all categories of people, to cater to children, to youth, to elderly people, to families, everybody. So that education system should be there, and Bhakti Shastri is one among such educational ventures. So this is some classroom norms, but we'll not discuss this now. We'll discuss this once we actually start the class. Yeah, Prabhupada says here, just like if you enter into any educational institution, if you don't surrender yourself to the rules and regulations of the institution, how you can get advantage of the knowledge imparted by the institution? All of you have gone to college or school, it will have some rules. You have to be present at this time. Okay, and you have to write the exams. You have to have minimum passing percentage. So there is some rules which the education institution sets. Similarly, in ISKCON also, Prabhupada has set the standard for education here. And one has to surrender to those rules and regulations of the institution. Like when we take initiation, at that time we tell 16 rounds and following 4 Yogi principles. That means one is surrendered. And also not only that, but reading Prabhupada books, attending classes, punctuality, developing the qualities of humility, responsibility for learning. So we'll see the 12 aims of Bhakti Shastri course. We'll see about it later when we actually start the course. We'll see the 12 aims of Bhakti Shastri course. So now I will request one of you to unmute your mic and read some of these quotes which will be coming on the screen. Anybody would like to volunteer? Please raise your hand, I'll unmute you. Because there are 40 people, it may create chaos. Any one of you can volunteer. Okay, we have Vikas Prabhu volunteering. Yes, Vikas Prabhu.
Everywhere, wherever you want to receive something, you have to be controlled or you have to be surrendered to the rules and regulations. If you do not follow the rules and regulations of this class, it is not possible to receive the knowledge.
Okay. So one has to follow the rules and regulations of the class. Prabhupada is telling this in San Francisco, 1968. In the early days only, Prabhupada is setting the standard that how one should be punctual, one should follow the rules and regulations of the ISKCON society. So let's go ahead. Let's see what Prabhupada is telling here about Shastri courses. So there are basically four Shastri courses which Prabhupada himself instituted. There is one letter that Prabhupada is writing that in ISKCON is instituted of these four courses: Bhakti Shastri, the next is Bhakti Vaibhava, Bhakti Vedanta, Bhakti Sarvabhauma. Now today we are, you know, giving introduction to Bhakti Shastri course, which is basically study of four books, which is Bhagavad Gita, full Bhagavad Gita, 18 chapters, Nectar of Devotion, the first part. In Nectar of Devotion, there are four parts, so only the first part will be taught in Bhakti Shastri. And then Nectar of Instruction and Ishopanishad. These four books are part of Bhakti Shastri. And Bhakti Vaibhava consists of first six cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhakti Vedanta is the last six cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam. And Bhakti Sarvabhauma includes Chaitanya Charitamrita. So this is the way Prabhupada designed this course. Now, what do you hope to achieve by studying Bhakti Shastri course? Like all of you have come here and you have opted to attend this program. So I want to hear from a couple of you. What is your expectation? What is your interest? Why you are opting to join this Bhakti Shastri course? Okay, so we have some people raising the hands. Okay, we'll give Prashant Prabhu. Okay. You want to speak? And there is Purna Nandini Mataji.
Prabhu, my plan is to understand systematically and deeply into the Bhagavad Gita and Ishopanishad. Just generally we'll read as a general subject or just to understand, but deep understanding is very much essential.
Okay. Thank you, Prashant. Yes, Purna Nandini Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. To understand in depth what exactly Srila Prabhupada is trying to convey us through his books. This is what.
Okay, so both of you say in depth understanding you wanted to have. Okay, thank you. Anybody else would like to share? We have Sudarshan Brajeshwar Prabhu.
Yeah. Hare Krishna Prabhuji. So I want to attend this course. The reason being, as Advait said, yes, to get in-depth understanding of this, and at the same time, we will become more serious if we are attending a course rather than doing it ourselves. So there is a mentor who will be helping us to be able to get deeper understanding of it, and at the same time they will help us to progress further, right? The different aspects of understanding. If we read ourselves, we'll have one kind of an understanding, but if we are being mentored, there will be different understanding. And when we are with a group of people, we will definitely understand it in a much better way. And also it helps us, it gives us the confidence to use that subject to preach to others at the same time. That's what I feel. I'm looking forward from this course.
Okay, thank you, Sudarshan Prabhu. You told a very nice point that when some academic thing is introduced, then we are forced to study, right? When exams come, then students open their books and start studying. So Bhakti Shastri is also a very nice course where one automatically gets into the mode of study. So you'll see that whole year will be fully focused on Prabhupada books, Gita, Ishopanishad, and all these four books. It will be focused study. Yeah, thank you. Yes, Sita Rani Mataji, want to share?
Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, this is systematic understanding and how to apply it in practical daily life. Like, because once we learn this, then we will also try to understand like how to apply it, so that we live that all the instructions in the daily life more systematically.
Thank you. Practical application also, because when we study, then we can apply. Thank you. Venkatramanapur is also raising hand. We'll take one more only, then we'll go ahead with the PPT.
Yes, Prabhuji, if you read the books, like, it is not we are not reading in the systematic way or structured manner. Even we try to listen YouTube videos, but it is not in the structured manner, and also it's not in the what do you call it? If we get time, we do that. If we don't get time, we don't do that. But here, it's not the case. So it will be in the systematic and structured format where we can discuss with the mentor and we get the insights and how to apply. And now also, like, we are forced to study because of exams or because of these courses.
Okay. Thank you, bro. Thank you so much. So thank you, and everybody.
Help in preaching.
Help in preaching. Correct. When we study properly, we know how to preach, because we'll be thorough with all the sections of Bhagavad Gita. Demigods, okay, go to this chapter, 7th chapter, speak about demigods. What about going to heavens? Okay, there is one section here. What about next life? 8th chapter, 2nd chapter. So we'll have no, we'll get the whole idea of Bhagavad Gita and the Shastra. Immediately you can quote and establish the philosophy which you are preaching. Thank you. Yeah. Now, can somebody read this quote? Maybe Venkatramana Prabhu only can continue reading. Yeah.
Yes, Prabhu. Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela 25.278. All of the devotees connected with this Krishna consciousness movement must read all of the books that have been translated, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, and others. Otherwise, after they will simply eat, sleep, and fall down from their position. Thus, they will miss the opportunity to attain an eternal, blissful life of transcendental pleasure.
So, Prabhupada is telling this in the purport. If you don't read, then you'll eat, sleep, and waste time. Because when you read Prabhupada properly, we cannot sit quietly. We have to do some service. We'll be inspired to do some service. We cannot sit. But if you don't read and hear proper lectures, we'll waste our time simply eating and sleeping. So this is telling to devotees. Yeah, let's go ahead. Please read.
Study Bhagavad Gita as it is and Srimad Bhagavatam, and continue to help your God brothers in developing Krishna consciousness. Develop your preaching in this way, and this will be the most successful and appreciated endeavor. When you study very carefully all of the literatures which are available, especially Bhagavad Gita as it is, you will have in your grasp answers to all questions that may be put to you. Please encourage the others to read this Bhagavad Gita at least one chapter every day. Letter to Upendra, January 6th, 1969.
Yes, Prabhu is saying, study Bhagavad Gita, then it will help in your preaching. Right? When you study carefully, then you will have grasp of the knowledge and you can answer all the questions. And Bhagavad Gita has all the answers for the questions which people have. It may be Mayavadis, how to defeat Mayavadis, how to defeat other schools of philosophy, right? How to defeat Karmakandis. Everything is there in Bhagavad Gita. And not only that, but also how to practice Bhagavad Gita in our life. Everything is there here. So let's say 1969. Okay. Please continue.
I want you leaders especially to become absorbed in the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and become yourselves completely convinced and free from all doubt. On this platform, you shall be able to carry on the work satisfactorily. But if there is a lack of knowledge or if there is a forgetfulness, everything will be spoiled in time. So especially you must encourage the students to read our books throughout the day as much as possible and give them all good advice how to understand the books and inspire them to study the things from every point of view. Better to boil the milk very vigorously and make it thick and sweet. That is best progress. So let us concentrate on training our devotees very thoroughly in the knowledge of Krishna consciousness from our books, from tapes, by discussing always and in so many ways, instruct them in the right propositions. Letter to Hamsadutta, June 22, 1972.
Yeah, so Prabhupada is telling here, boil the milk. Boil the milk means what? When Prabhupada started preaching, many people became devotees. They started taking Krishna consciousness. But many were coming, but they were not so strong. They were becoming weak. So then Prabhupada introduces this concept called boil the milk. So first thing is getting the milk, which is called preaching. You go preach and get the milk. Milk means devotees. But later what you have to do? Boil the milk. Boiling means what? It becomes more thick and sweet. Boiling milk doesn't mean that the milk is reduced or thrown. No, it becomes more and more thick and condensed. Whatever devotees are coming, they become more thick, more sweet, more pakka. So that is the meaning of boiling the milk. So Bhakti Shastri course is mainly for serious practitioners, those who are chanting 16 rounds and are regular for all the temple programs and they are taking up some responsibilities in temple. So that's mainly for such kind of devotees who are serious about Krishna consciousness, not for very new people. Yeah. Please read.
See Krishna face to face. Nowadays, it seems that many of the older disciples like yourself are having difficulty. If you don't set the example for the younger students and take the responsibility for instructing them in the right line, how will things go on? Try to always study our books and see our philosophy from different lights of directions. Become convinced yourself of this knowledge, and without a doubt, all your difficulties of mind will disappear forever. And you will see Krishna face to face. Letter to Bhagavatananda, July 8th, 1972.
Yeah. So he's telling that analyze this books from different angles. Yes. He's telling someone that Prabhupada books are like diamond. When you read from this angle, you'll get a one kind of understanding. Another side, different understanding. Like diamond gives different light, different directions. Red, blue, yellow, green, like that. So when you come together and discuss, same purport can give different directions, different new revelations to the devotees. Right? And you will see Krishna face to face. All the doubts are vanquished. Vidyate hriday granti, chindate sarva samshayah, kshiyante chasya karmani, drushte ivatmanishwari. So all the doubts are vanquished and he sees Krishna. Okay, now we'd like to give somebody else also a chance to read. Somebody like to volunteer? I see Balaji Garu raising hand. Okay, we have Somohini Mataji. Okay, end it.
Yes, steadiness. Yes, as a sannyasi and GBC, your first duty is to read my books. Otherwise, how will you preach? In order to remain steadily fixed in Krishna consciousness, there must be a sound philosophical understanding. Otherwise, it will become only sentiment. Whenever you find the time, please read my books. Letter to Saptarupa Dasa Goswami, January 5th, 1976.
Yeah, so he's telling to sannyasis. Really, as one becomes senior, no? He becomes too much involved in management, too much involved in so many dealing with issues and all. But Prabhupada is telling, as a sannyasi, main duty is to read Prabhupada books. Okay. And also those who are preaching Krishna consciousness, for them also, they should read more than preach. Generally, what happens? We see that when class comes, then they read and then they speak. But actually, they should read more than what they speak. So that's what Prabhupada is telling here to sannyasis and GBCs. Read my books, read my books. There's another quote I was hearing in Prabhupada lecture where he was telling that one devotee asks a question, one disciple asks a question, Prabhupada, should you read your books or should you do other services? And Prabhupada becomes very strong and he says, actually, why am I writing these books, waking up whole night? I'm not doing time pass. He says that actually I'm not writing this book to make business. You think that I'm writing these books to sell it and get money? No, I'm writing this for my disciples. So first duty is, you should read my books. Like that Prabhupada is telling heavily. See, Prabhupada spent whole night writing. Sometimes he'll get up at 1 o'clock and start writing books from 1 o'clock onwards. So, and sometimes late night programs will be there. Prabhupada will come late, sleep late, and then continue writing. Hardly any sleep. I was reading that Prabhupada is traveling from one country to another country. From Japan, he comes to Hong Kong in middle of the night. And middle of the night, he starts giving a lecture. Arrival letters. And hardly any sleep. No sleeping actually. In the middle of the night, he comes, gives a lecture. Then he asks, what is the time? Okay, it's time for morning walk. Let's go for a walk. And then again, he goes for a walk and gives lecture and then takes prasad and whole day program. So no sleep. So such kind of schedule Prabhupada is following. So at least out of gratitude, we should read his books thoroughly. What he has written, we should read it. Okay. Yes. Yeah, so who would like to read? Okay, Ramakrishna.
Yes, Prabhuji. Read and apply. Yes, reading my books will help you. Philosophy must be there, but if you do not also apply the philosophy by participating in all temple affairs, like rising early, attending Mangalarati, performing devotional service, then simply learning the philosophy will have no effect. Letter to Dayananda, July 7,
1972. Yeah. See, there are two things. One is philosophy and then is practice. If one is reading only philosophy but not practicing, that will remain only in the head. It will not transform into action, because it's not transformed into action, there will be no heart transformation. Philosophy should lead to heart transformation. So Prabhupada is telling here, if you don't rise early in the morning, if you don't attend Mangalarati, you don't chant 16 rounds in the morning, then whatever we are reading, hearing, is just waste. There's no effect. And then another extreme is, they will do only seva, 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 and then they will not study. Can anybody tell me what is the drawback of this? They do only seva, 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 but they do not study Prabhupada books. What will happen? What will happen to such people? And why is it wrong? Yes, who would like to say? Okay, Ravi Ganapati Guru. Balaji Guru also.
Hare Krishna. It might be possible that it will be like, as in one of the quotes Prabhupada is saying, it will just become a sentiment, and there are chances that they will fall down from their current state.
It will become a sentiment. Very nice point. Sentiment is what? Okay, I'm just doing because I like it. But he doesn't know the philosophy behind why he is doing what he is doing. So because of that, that will not go for a long time. Yeah. So thank you, Prabhu, Sudarshan Prabhu. Yes, Balaji Prabhu, want to share something?
Yes, the practical knowledge of actually doing only service and not understanding the philosophy, right? And so it's just like doing a study, only understanding the theory and not doing any practicals in our regular existence.
Okay.
So I think we need to have some practicals and also go into beyond the
practicals. Okay. Thank you, Prabhuji. So you're telling that theory is like studying theory but not doing practicals, so you cannot understand the theory properly. Correct. In fact, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati says, like, service is like the digesting the philosophy. Right? Attending classes is like hearing philosophy, like eating food. But then doing service is like digesting it. Like when you eat food and simply sleep, it will not get digested. You have to do some physical work, then it gets digested. Similarly, just hearing is not sufficient. One has to also practically do service. So that's why, apart from doing Bhakti Shastri course, studying this philosophy, all of you should also take up some responsibility, some service. In coming to temple, washing pots or cleaning or serving prasadam, something. Or in COVID time, maybe in home also you can do your services, doing deity worship and arranging Zoom programs. Some service should be there. That service will digest the philosophy. That's what Prabhupada is telling him. Okay. Can somebody read this? Okay. Ravi Ganapati Guru, raising hand.
Yes, Prabhu. Nothing outside Srila Prabhupada books. There is no need to any of my disciples to read any books besides my books. In fact, such reading may be detrimental to their advancement in Krishna consciousness, except in certain authorized cases. For example, to read some philosopher like Plato, to make an essay comparing his philosophy with Krishna's philosophy. But otherwise, all such outside reading should be stopped immediately. It is simply another another botheration. If my students cannot even read my own books thoroughly, why should they read others? I have given you TLC.
Teachings of Lord Chaitanya.
Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. What need is there to read Chaitanya Charitamrita translated by someone else? You are right to stop such reading. Letter to Sri Govinda.
So, Prabhu is saying no need to read other books. But if it is required for preaching, then under a direction, one can read other books. So, initially, we should stick to Prabhupada purports and then try to understand Prabhupada purports rather than reading other philosophers and other commentaries. So, it will just disturb the mind. Bahu Shastra, Bahu Vakya, Chitte Brahma Hai. Chaitanya Charitamrita says, too much reading will also disturb the mind because there may be some little differences in what they are presenting. Same thing, but differently they are presenting. So that may create some confusions. So better to stick to Prabhupada purports. And once we are thorough with Prabhupada purports, we have understood it properly, then under the direction one may read other books only if necessary. Okay. So go ahead. Yes, Balaji, Prabhu, want to read?
Yes, Prabhu. I am understanding some varieties.
Oh, there's a lot of echo there. Lot of echo in your speech.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, Prabhu. Yeah, please speak.
Understanding from varieties of angles.
Yeah.
I am very much stressing at this point that all my students shall be very much conversant with the philosophy of Krishna consciousness and that they should read our books very diligently, at least 1 or 2 hours daily, and try to understand the subject matter from varieties of angles. Letter to Madhu the Dvisa, June 16, 1972. Hare Krishna.
Okay. We'll go to the next quote. Yeah, please read. There are some couple of quotes now. We will take one by one quote. Yeah. I think Balaji Puranli can continue reading.
Okay. Read and follow. In my books, the philosophy of Krishna consciousness is explained fully. So if there's anything you do not understand, then you simply have to read again and again. By reading daily, the knowledge will be revealed to you. And by this process, your spiritual life will develop. You may please me the most by reading my books and following the instructions therein. Letter to Bahurupa, November
22nd, 1974. Yeah. Actually, this reading again and again is very important. Some people think, okay, Bhagavad Gita padh liya ek bar. I'll keep it on the shelf. No. But read again and again because many concepts you don't understand. My personal experience also, since 2006, we are reading Prabhupada books, but when we read again and again and again, some purports are understood now. That time we just skipped it, but now we are able to understand. Okay. Sitarani Mataji can read this.
A devotee in Mayapur once got to leave in the middle of one of Prabhupada's lectures. Where is he going? Prabhupada asked. He has some work to do, a devotee answered. This drew fire from Prabhupada. What work? Nonsense. Unless you hear, what work can you do? It will just be karma unless you hear. We cannot just read the books and do nothing for the spiritual master. But neither can we serve without the knowledge gained by reading the books. As Prabhupada states, I need to lower that.
Please speak. You're audible.
As Prabhupada states in the letter quoted above, we must both read the books and follow the instructions. This is the combination that pleases the spiritual master the most. By Sat Swarup Das Goswami.
So both has to be done. Hear, because if you don't hear or read, then we don't understand Guru's instruction. If you don't read Prabhupada books properly, then we don't know what Prabhupada wants us to do. So then we'll not be able to serve properly. So first thing is to know what Prabhupada wants us to do. Generally in GBC meetings and all, in senior devotees meetings, what they do, if some issue comes, they discuss what Prabhupada said about this in Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam and letters. So based on Prabhupada's letters and teachings, they make a decision. And if we don't know only what Prabhupada is telling about the subject matter, then how can we make a decision? right? So we should know thoroughly. Again, please read.
Aims of Bhakti Shastra. I think you may have already heard that in January of 1970, we will be holding an examination among all of our students on this book, and those who will pass shall be awarded with the title of Bhakti Shastra.
Please continue.
With these examinations, I wish to encourage all my disciples to very carefully learn this philosophy of Krishna consciousness, because there are so many preachers required to bring this message to all the corners of the earth. Letter to Mahapurusha, Los Angeles, 7th February 1969.
See, in 1969 only Prabhupada is making this system of Bhakti Shastri. Prabhupada inaugurated ISKCON in 66. 66, 67, 66, and just 4 years. And devotees who are joined movement are just 3-4 years old. And to them, Prabhupada is introducing this exam system. And here most of the devotees have, I think, spent a lot of many years in Krishna consciousness. And it is must that all of us all take this Bhakti Shastri course very seriously. Yeah, again, Prabhupada tells same. Please continue.
Examinations. Next January, there will be an examination on this Bhagavad Gita. Papers will be sent to me by all centers, and those securing the minimum passing grade will be given the title of Bhakti Shastra. Similarly, another examination will be held on Lord Chaitanya's appearance day in February 1970, and it will be upon Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita. Those passing will get the title of Bhakti Vaibhava. Another examination will be held sometime in 1971 on the four books, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya, and the Nectar of Devotion. One who will pass the examination will be awarded with the title of Bhakti Vedanta. I want all my spiritual sons and daughters will inherit in this title of Bhakti Vedanta, so that the family transcendental diploma of Bhakti Vedanta will continue through the organization.
Yeah. See, Prabhupada is Bhakti Vedanta. Yeah, Prabhupada is Bhakti Vedanta Swami. He wanted his followers to also carry this title Bhakti Vedanta by reading all the books. Okay. So, Bhakti Shastri, Bhakti Vaibhav, Bhakti Vedanta. So, mainly Gita, Nectar of Devotion, Nectar of Instruction, Ishopanishad, Bhagavatam, complete Bhagavatam, 12 cantos. So they should be thorough with this. That was the desire of Prabhupada. So we are not doing something very new in ISKCON. We are just implementing what Prabhupada had desired in 1969. Same thing is being implemented now. It took a lot of time to implement, and now it has come into full implementation.
Those possessing the title of Bhakti Vedanta will be allowed to initiate disciples. Maybe in 1975, all my disciples will be allowed to initiate and increase the numbers of generations. This is my program. So we should not simply publish these books for reading by outsiders, but our students must be well versed in all of our books so that we can be prepared to defeat all opposing parties in the matter of self-realization. Letter to Hamsaduta, December 3, 1968.
Yeah, so Prabhupada wanted those devotees in guru position to take up these courses very seriously. Okay, so that they'll be able to defeat other philosophies and establish Vaishnava Siddhanta. Okay. Brahmana Pandit.
Brahmana Pandit. In this way, you have to understand by studying carefully the philosophy. We have got so many books now, and I want all of my disciples to read them carefully. Soon, we shall be instituting Bhakti Shastri examinations and all the Brahmanas will have to pass. Letter to Upendra, January 7th, 1969. Also, you must see that...
Please continue.
Also, you must see that the Brahmanas are given sufficient time to read the books. Soon, we shall be introducing the Bhakti Shastri examination, which all Brahmanas will be expected to pass. It will be based on Bhagavad Gita, the Nectar of Devotion, Nectar of Instruction, Ishopanishad, and the small paperback books like Easy Journey. A Brahmana should be Pandita. Letter to Vrishakapi, January 7, 1976.
See, Brahmana means one who is learned, one who knows Shastra, he is called Brahmana. So in ISKCON also, Brahman Diksha is given for those who are worshipping deities. So it is expected that they know the Siddhanta of the deity worship. They know the Siddhanta of who is Archa Vigraha, who is Krishna. So they should be able to establish the truths from the Shastra. So Brahma Janati iti Brahmana. So, and Brahmani is expected to know all the Shastras, like Veda, Pathad, Bhaved, Vipraha, Samskarad, Bhaved, Vijaha. So all those things are there. So he should know the Samskaras, he should know the Shastras, then he is qualified as a Brahmana, not just by wearing a thread. So now in ISKCON also, they have made it mandatory that anybody who wants to go for second initiation, Brahman initiation, one should have completed Bhakti Shastri course. It's mandatory. Okay. Please read.
Aims of Bhakti Shastri. After the student studies the Vedas under the master of some time, for some time, at least from age 5 to 20, he must become a man of perfect character. Study of the Vedas is not meant for the recreation of armchair speculators, but for the formation of character. Bhagavad Gita 8.28 Bhagavad.
So aim of Bhakti Shastri is not just academical study, memorizing all the shlokas, and showing that, okay, I know so much purports of Prabhupada. No, it's also meant to reform character, means what? One should become more humble, one should become more service attitude should come in the heart, right? One should take a more responsibility for Srila Prabhupada. So that is the kind of transformation, character, and all the anarthas should go away from the heart, and one should become more clean and pure. So that is the end goal of studying Bhakti Shastri apart from academic study. So there are three things here: knowledge, skills, and values. So Bhakti Shastri will help us to develop all these three. Knowledge means theoretical knowledge, which later transforms into understanding and then realization. Okay. So next slide I will show you. That is called the stage of Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. So that is knowledge. Second is skills. There are latent abilities in our personality. We develop those skills and then apply it in our life. Like somebody knows kirtan, but it's latent in his heart. So he develops that skill of kirtan and he engages in Krishna service. And then values, there are innate qualities in the personality of the soul. The soul has got wonderful qualities. Amanittam, Madambittam, Ahimsa, Shanti, Rajam, like many qualities are mentioned in Bhagavad Gita. So, but it is covered with anarthas now. So removing unwanted things and manifesting the good qualities. So the real qualities of the soul manifested outside. So that is the goal of Bhakti Shastri, to develop knowledge, skills, and values. See here in Vedic evidence, there. Yeah. So any learning process has three broad stages. First is Shravana, which is hearing from the teacher. Second is Manana, gaining an intellectual understanding by reflecting on what is learned. Okay, when you hear, I am not this body, I am spirit soul, that's Shravana. But when you start thinking about it, contemplating on it, that's called Manana. And Nididhyasana means realization and living according to this realization. So Nididhyasana. So living with understanding that I am the soul. So that is Nididhyasana. So one has to develop this stage. So it happens gradually. There's another four stages, Prabhupada says. Adhiti means to learn the subject. Jignyasitam, adhitam cham. Adhitam means to understand the subject matter. Then bodha means to gain insight and proficiency in one's learning. Okay, to become expert in that knowledge. That is bodha. And acharana means realizing the purpose of and living according to our learning. Right? Walking our talk. So that is acharana. And then pracharana, giving this knowledge to others. Achara and then prachara. So the knowledge develops in these four stages. Without aim, what is the use of practice? Yeah, somebody can read this. Please raise your hand. Okay, Sudarshan. Yes.
If without aim, what is the use of practice? If you have no goal, there is example. Man without any aim is ship without any rudder. So suppose if airplane is going with an aim to land in some country, but if he goes on simply without any aim, then there will be disaster. So without aim, what is the use of practice? That is foolishness. Without goal, practicing is foolishness. Room conversation, June 13, 1974, Paris.
Yeah. So for Bhakti Shastri also, we have a specific aim. So there are 12 goals of Shastric study, which will be told in the first session. When we start the actual course, they will tell you the 12 aims. So it's very, very clear what objective we want to attain by this course. Okay. So one of the aims is to help students understand and appreciate the mood and mission of Srila Prabhupada and to perpetuate that understanding within ISKCON society. So to understand what Prabhupada wants from us, his mood, and to propagate it, because Prabhupada is our founder Acharya. And how can we know the mood of founder Acharya? Through his books. So that's why we should study his books thoroughly. Okay, so now I will complete my part of this presentation. Now I'd like to request His Grace Karunamurthy Prabhu to tell about how this classes will be conducted, what will be the pattern, and then we'll discuss about the timings. Okay.
Can I share my PPT?
Okay. Yes, you can share now. So His Grace Karunamurthy Prabhu is, we were together in Pune for many years serving in ISKCON NVCC. He was helping there in the temple by giving a lot of education to children. He was part of one school called Vidyashrama, where all the community devotee children used to come morning. They still come there, and they'll have classes for them in the morning, like morning program. And he was also part of Gurukul, which is being run there under the direction of Srila Prabhupada going through there in Gurukul in Pune. And also he was also coordinator of many courses like IDC and Bhakti Shastri for Pune temple devotees and congregation. So, and he is here with us in Bangalore, and he agreed to coordinate our courses here in ICC. So very thankful to him, and he is there with us staying in ICC. So welcome him by chanting Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna. Am I audible?
Yes.
So coming to the last part, which is course overview and the assessments. So two parts I will explain. I have four slides. So how the whole course is going to the flow. So all these four books we have divided, the book MIHES divided into five units, which are the Bhagavad Gita into three units, which is first six chapters, and then next middle six and the last six chapters. And Nectar of Devotion, first 19 chapters, that will be one unit. And Ishopanishad and Upadeshamrit, NY, will together be one unit. So we will go like, first we'll take Nectar of Instruction, and then Ishopanishad, then NOD, then we'll start from Bhagavad Gita first chapter. Because if you start with Bhagavad Gita, it may take, because it takes more time. So at least we'll get some accomplishment by doing two books very fast. So we have, when we get some accomplishment, something we have achieved, it's because it's going to be 2 years course almost. So something we achieve, then we get confidence. Yes, something we have done, only few things are remaining. So that's why we'll start with the Nectar of Instructions first, and then Ishopanishad, NOD, then Bhagavad Gita. So each unit will take certain time. It may vary for Bhagavad Gita, first six chapters, if you see in the slide, 12 to 18 lessons, 12 to 18 classes. So each class duration, we may go around 2 hours approximately, which includes kirtan in the beginning and then question and answers at the end. For Bhagavad Gita, totally it takes around 40 to 45 sessions. I mean 45 weeks, because we are going to it once in a week. Then Nectar of Devotion, which will again may take 10 to 14 lessons. That means 28 hours approximately. Ishopanishad and Nectar of Instruction together also will take that much time, 12 to 16 lessons of 32 hours total. So while we are doing this course every day after every lesson, which takes 2 hours session, so at the same amount of time, each participant has to spend separately in that week for self-study, also to write their open book assessments. Because open book assessments, we can start writing from the day one the class starts, because it takes time, because you have to understand, study, understand, and then write on your own words. We'll come to that assessment part next slide. So totally it's going to take 150 to 160 hours. That means 74, 75 lessons. Approximately 2 years or less than that. If you go, if you're considering there are yatras, devotees go on vacations and other festivals, the temple. So some weeks it may not happen. So considering all those things, within 2 years it will be completed. And if you want to do it a little fast, whenever devotees get some vacations, some government holidays along with the Saturday, Sunday, then sometimes we can do 2 days or 1 day camp where we can spend more time and completing more lessons. Like in a day we can do 2 lessons or 5 to 6 hours, like that we can do, then the total duration can be reduced and we can do it fast. So, and then open book. Okay, I'll come to the assessment part next. So it has open book assessment. Open book assessment means you, there are questions in the handbook, student handbook, which will give you. So in that, there are, for every unit, there are open book assessment, I mean the questions, based on personal and application, preaching application, mood and mission, understanding or knowledge. So based on this, based on the dual aims of Bhakti Shastri, knowledge, skills, values. So based on that, there are open book questions. So when we start writing the day one, by the end of the unit, we'll be able to complete those questions. And there is no need to fear or worry about the assessment part, because open book assessments are going to be very easy if we do it regularly. I mean, when the every week when the lesson starts, lesson completes, then you do it, then it's going to be easy. Otherwise, if you have to sit and write just before the exam, it is going to be very tough. And then we come to the, of course, this open book assessment has to be completed and submitted before or at the end of each unit, because at the end of each unit, there is going to be closed book exam, which is very easy. So no need to take a worry or fear, because we may have, some devotees may have phobia about exams, because we have given these exams long back in school days, college days, and to again come back and sit and write 2 hours exam preparation. It's going to be a nice thing to see parents are preparing for the exam and children are watching. So, but it is going to be very relishing, because these are not subjects like academic outside subjects, which we know these subjects, and there are many devotees to help to understand. So closed book exam will be very easy, because most of the questions will be coming from the student handbook which we'll give you. There are questions at the end of each unit. And from the books of Prabhupada. So open. So that's about closed book. Next is sloka test. Of course, the sloka test will be part of closed book assessment, because each unit, at the end of each unit, when closed book exam is conducted, so there will be verses concerned to that textbook, which will be coming in the closed book exam. And those slokas also are mentioned in our student handbook, which we'll give you. So in that, there are very few verses. You don't have to worry about even this, that verses also, because those verses will be at the beginning of every class, we'll be reciting it. By end of that unit, you'll memorize it. Separately, you don't have to endeavor. Of course, the marks, of course, I forgot to mention. For open book assessment, the passing mark will be 50%. And the out of 100 marks or percentage, 65% that has value, because open book assessment is the one which really assesses our understanding, because we have to write it with our own words. We cannot just copy from the book and then write it. So you read it, but we have to write it with our own words, with our understanding. So that carries more value than the closed book. Closed book is just a memory, like we any other school exam we do, cram and vomit. It is going to be like that. But open book is the one which really assesses our understanding. And memorization of verses will be taken care. And sadhana also will be considered 5% in our total score, based on which Bhakti Shastri degree will be awarded. How we are regularly doing our sadhana, and then participation in the class with attendance, punctuality, and other aspects. So this about assessments. And we'll be giving you a student handbook, which will contain all these questions, open book assessment questions, closed book questions, and each unit overview and the notes. So before coming to the each unit, starting of the unit, there are questions based on the book, Prabhupada books, Purva Swadhyaya, which is called preliminary study questions. So when we study that questions, you'll understand what is there in that chapter, those chapters are in that unit. And there are analogies which also will come in our closed book exams and examples. So most of the closed book exams will be from our student handbook. So don't need to worry about exams. Nobody need to have any phobia or fear of exams. It is going to be very relishing, because when we sit and write for our OBA open book assignment or closed book exams, our contemplation, thinking about, you know, Krishna or understanding of philosophy or Prabhupada books, that gives more absorption in Krishna than anything else. Because we had experience during Bhakti Vaibhav or even Bhakti Shastri also. We think so much, how to understand this, what is the answer, what is the sloka also, sometimes we forget. But that process of thinking, contemplation, which is more purifying, and we will relish it. That's about assessment and the course overview on the student handbook. So now I leave it to the devotees. If they have any doubts, concerns, questions on this Bhakti Shastri course, you can ask. So anything I missed?
Yeah, thank you so much for giving the overview of the assessment and exams. So it'll be a very interesting course. Coming to the point about most of the devotees may be having question about online, offline. So actually we also wanted to mold our session based on devotees' need also, and devotees taking into consideration your inputs also. So now we wanted to have it offline in temple, and Corona again started, Corona wave, and COVID cases are increasing. So then we thought it to have offline. So now, online. So now the session will be online on Zoom. But in case after, because this is going to be a long course, about 1.5 years to two years, we should be able to finish it in 1.5 year if you have it regularly, without any breaks. We can finish it. In case the corona wave goes down and then things become normal, so we wanted to take your opinion whether would you prefer physical classes in temple or you want fully online. So you might be seeing a poll on your screen, so kindly put your vote. Okay, so 18 have voted, 20 have voted. So everybody please press your button, select one of the two. Okay, so 26 have only voted. Remaining devotees, please vote. Okay. So it's almost a tie. 50-50. 50-50. So 15 devotees, about 29 devotees have voted, and 15 are preferring physical class. So somebody is saying, I cannot see the poll. You can type on the chat box if you cannot see the poll. You can type, you want physical or online. So, okay, prefer online. Okay. So I'm ending the poll here. Okay, so this is the poll result. So almost 50-50. So we'll keep it online. And once things become normal, we may also start physical class. And those who are in home, they may attend online. So it may be dual, physical as well as broadcast through Zoom. So once COVID becomes normal, we may follow that pattern. Okay, so offline from, okay, Venkatraman is staying offline, Utkarsh Mataji online, some say online, some say offline. Okay, so till COVID is there, so we'll follow fully online. And in case COVID reduces, then we may have both more. Those who prefer to come here to temple, can come to temple, and then others can attend online. Now regarding timings, oh, somebody is in UK, but is connected to ICC. Sudarshan Brajeshwar. UK timing suits you? Okay, I'll allow people to unmute. Okay, it suits you, fine. Now regarding timings, now I'll launch another poll. Are you okay with the timing Sunday afternoon, 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock? So this is a time when there is no preaching, because some of you may be having preaching programs in the evening, on Saturday evenings, Sunday evenings. I also have preaching programs, Saturday, Sunday evenings. But afternoons is peaceful time, and it is much better. So devotees can come for Sunday program, then attend a Sunday program, take prasad, meet devotees, and stay back, and then attend the whole Bhakti Shastri class, and then go back home. So in, with that consideration, we chose this time, 1 to 3, especially for congregation. Okay, we have 21 devotees voted till now, 23, 24. Okay. Everybody has voted. Okay. Okay. Sudarshan Prabhu also telling 1 o'clock is perfect for UK. Okay. Thank you. Okay, I'll end the poll here. 29 devotees have voted. So here's the poll result. So 86% are okay with Sunday afternoon. So I think we'll fix this. Karanamruti Pro and us, we'll fix this time. So Sunday and others, maybe if you can adjust your timing to this timing, because most of them prefer this time. So we'll go by this timing. And some are 66% are ready for weekly once, and 34% are ready for weekly twice. Okay. I just put that because just wanted to know if you do it weekly twice, then one can finish it within 1 year also. There are some people who are doing courses weekly thrice and they are finishing the Bhakti Shastri in 4 months. But that will be very intense because you'll have to put same amount of endeavor studying, self-study also. So because it requires self-study, those who have time, that is possible. But generally for working people, it may not be possible. Weekly once should be good enough, or maximum weekly twice. Okay, we'll keep it weekly once, and then Sunday, 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock. So timing is fixed, frequency is fixed. Okay. And now if you have any questions, you can unmute and ask your questions.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Can you hear me?
Yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, my question was, I was seeing that assessment. It talked about 50% and then off 60. So should I read as 50% off 65%? That's how you see it on all the parameters. In that slide, there was percentage was varying from various
categories. Percentage total is 100.
Yeah, it's total out of 100 marks of Bhakti Shastri assessment. I mean, for each book. For 50%, let me open that slide.
For each unit, each unit assessment will be there.
Yes.
For the 5 units, each unit will have OBA and closed book exam.
Okay. Yeah, so that I understood. My question passing, was, yes. Yeah, sorry, there was a passing percentage was something mentioned there.
Yeah, can I show that PPT?
Yes, you can. See.
That'll be helpful.
Yes. Is it visible now?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yes. Sorry. So your doubt is 65% is mentioned and then 50% pass mark.
That's right. Problem.
Yeah. So 65% is a total weightage for that open book assessment of that unit, which includes 20% of closed book assessment versus 10% and sadhana 5%. That is total out of 100 marks. And the 50% pass mark is in the open book assessment, the passing mark is 50%. That means you have to write, your answer has to be 50% correct.
Okay. Okay. So in each of the parameters, you have to meet those criteria.
Yeah. In the each unit, like if you example for NY, we conduct exam, closed book and open book. So in the open book assessment, you write, may say you write 4 questions. The answers. So in the out of 4 questions, the total marks which you get, it should be 50%. If you get less than 50% marks, say if it is 100 marks for the open book, 100 for the 4 questions, and if you get only 50 and above, then you are passed. If you get say 49 marks, then it's like we have to again write that.
Okay, Prabhu. Thank you.
Yeah. Same if our closed book also. Best. Okay.
Okay. Yes. So thank you, Prabhu. And there is some question about course fees. Course fee will be 5,000 rupees for the entire course. Initially, we had put it 6,500. But now because it's online, there's no prasadam expenses. So we're putting it 5,000 rupees. Okay. So, and course fees should be paid to the temple account. So once all of you register, we'll be making a WhatsApp group and we'll be sharing the account details. I'll take account number from Pramonitai Prabhu and put it there in the Google form itself. So you can pay there. And if somebody has any concerns of Lakshmi, one can pay in installments also. So one can pay in installments. That facility is also available. So those who already filled the form, no need to fill again. So Shivaram Krishna Prabhu, he will be the coordinator. So he will be sending communications. He will be sending the course timings, updates. He will be sharing the materials to all of you. So he will be like an interface between us and all the class. He will be class representative. He is also part of this course. And he will be like a CR. He will be coordinating and communicating to all the devotees. Okay. And Prabhu, only initiated devotees are supposed to take the... No, anybody can take this course, provided your chanting Dikshin notes and connected to temple properly. And also, you should take a recommendation from your counselor or circle servant. So, you should inform them, and with their permission, you can join this course. Okay. Okay, so any other questions?
The recordings will be available. If you miss any classes or anything.
Recordings, yeah, I think we can arrange for audio recordings. Videos.
Not so, like future, huh? Future. I mean, actual classes recordings.
Yeah, for future only. Yes, we can try to record. Or we want video or audio?
Audio, Prabhu. At least audio would be very helpful.
At least audio. Yeah, surely.
That would be very helpful. Yeah.
Yes. Video will become too many series.
File size would become very big. Yeah, it will be a little more difficult.
So we can make a MP3 format and we can make a folder. Our Shivaram Krishnapura has created one account, Google account, Gmail account. For Bhakti Shastri 2021. So in that drive, we'll be putting all these recordings. Then you can take it from there. So all the course material, we'll have one centralized cloud where all the course materials, informations will be put up there. So any materials you can download from there. Okay.
Recordings that'll be also. Very good. That would be very good.
Eligibility criteria, it is mentioned that we should have read all the four books once.
Yes.
So is it mandatory?
Yes. See, Bhakti Shastri course, eligibility criteria, chanting 16 notes, following four regular principles. You must be recommended by local temple president, local authority, and certifying that your fear will be engaged in preaching mission Lord Chaitanya for past 1 year. They should have read Nectar of Devotion, first part, not fully, at least the first 19 chapters. Nectar of Instruction, Bhagavad Gita, Ishopanishad. And Leelamrit, at least the condensed version of Leelamrit, you should have read so that you understand how much pain Prabhupada took to write these books. If you know Prabhupada's life, then you can understand Prabhupada's purports also nicely. So we'll be starting with Nectar of Instruction first. So those who have not read, at least read it once. It's a very small book. You can read in 1 or 2 days. You can finish it. Okay. So then Ishopanishad you can read. Then Nectar of Devotion. So at least these three books you can read. And try to... Because what happens if you know, if you have read it once, then it will become easy for you when you come for classes. If you are not at all read any books, then it may be difficult to grasp the subject matter. So at least once you go through. Okay. Now, first, next week, we'll be starting Nectar of Instruction. So in this week, you can try to complete Nectar of Instruction. Very small book it is, but very important book. Okay, 75% attendance is must for getting Bhakti Shastri degree. Yes, one should have that much attendance. Then there is, how will the closed book test be conducted? Yeah, it's a challenge on Zoom. So generally what other schools and colleges are doing, everybody comes on Zoom and one initiator is watching everybody on the video. So, and there are some criteria. We should not be away from the video for more than some seconds. And video should be, and your full, like half part should be visible, right? So that you're seeing writing the exam. So all those things, we may have to do all that things. So we'll tell if. Okay. What if I have not read? Can I join? Yeah, you can join the course, but before that particular chapter starts, you should read and come. That homework you should do. Before that particular section is being taught, you should read it once and then come for the class. Otherwise, what will happen? The basic questions will be asked, and then small basic discussions will happen, and then it may waste the classroom time. So prior reading is better to get best advantage, take best out of the classes. Yeah, they can register and complete reading before the session starts. That will be great. All the classes will be on Zoom only. Keshav Gaur is asking, yeah, right now because of COVID, it will be on Zoom. And once the COVID ends, Krishna willing, this year it would end. And then we will have contact classes also. So devotees can come to temple and you can attend from here. And those who are away, maybe they can connect on Zoom. So we'll try to arrange for both dual Zoom as well as contact classes. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. With whom should we just have these names registered? I'm sorry, I missed that name. Can you give the contact number or?
No, there's one form, Google form.
Okay. I'll take it from there.
Just put it there. And you can just add your register there.
Sure, Prabhu.
Okay, we'll get all your contacts. And those numbers will be added to the WhatsApp group. And then communications will be sent through that.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Okay. Any other questions? One form for each devotee, or can we fill one form? One form for each devotee. If you are a family, please fill one form for husband and wife, separate forms. Okay.
Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, yes. Can we get the recording of this orientation program?
Yes, it will be uploaded.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, any other questions? We already have about 15 devotees registered before this orientation. And now we have about 16 devotees registered. Okay, so others also please fill up these forms. So when we have a good team, then we can have wonderful discussions and we can relish. It is said in Paraspara Anukatanam Pavanam Bhagavad Yashah Mito Ratihi Mitastushti Nivrittir Mita Atmana. When you do mutual Krishna Katha, then automatically there will be Mito Ratihi, there will be attraction for Krishna. Mitastushti, there will be satisfaction of the heart. Nivritti Mita Atmana, one will forget sense gratification. So these three things will happen by mutually discussing Krishna Katha. Okay, Hare Krishna.
How many lessons will be there, Prabhuji?
Around 70 to 75 lessons.
17 or 75?
Around 70 to 75, around approximately that much. So each lesson will be 2 hours.
We need to write that open book, na, Prabhuji. So, it will be end of one unit.
Yeah. At the end of one unit, you must submit the open book. So there will be 5 submissions for 5 units.
Okay. So this one unit will take a lot of time, Prabhuji.
Karunavarti, one unit may take about...
Yeah, it depends on the book. NY Ishwarpanish is very fast.
Mm.
Of course, that has 2 submissions, the total 6.
Mm.
NY and the Isha Upanishad. It's 2 books. So there are 2 submissions separately.
Okay. The Nectar of Devotion separate.
Yeah. NOD is separate.
So total 6 submissions.
Yeah. NY will take around 7 to 8 lessons. 7 to 8 weeks. Yes, 2 months.
Okay.
So here the submission means, Prabhuji, till like we should be on writing, and whenever that part is over, we need to submit.
Yes. Suppose if you are doing NY, and by the end of NY textbook, okay, then you need to, you can write it on the paper. Best is if you can type it on the computer. Those who cannot type, you can write by hand, because you can preserve it later, and so that it doesn't get lost. By end of that book, you submit it. Then we'll have closed book exam after that.
There will be deadline set up for each unit. There will be a deadline of submission, so by that date you can submit. Okay. Like maybe like 1 week or 2 weeks after the unit is over, time will be set up. By that time you can submit.
Yeah, but it's best if it is better if they start writing from the day one, because you will not be able to remember everything after the unit, after say 2 months. So if you start writing from the day one, because you will have for each unit, there may be 4 questions, open book questions you will have to write. So if you start from the day one, it will be easy for you to compile, at least make a skeleton and compile it. And later, keep adding. Later on, you can, at the end, you may do it the final touch and then submit. But if you start doing it day one, it is easy. Nothing will fall on your head at the end. Everything will come otherwise at your time.
So, open book is like a reference for the closed?
No. Open book is for your understanding how there are our personal application understanding, preaching application. The questions of different based on understanding are based on application are based on preaching application, personal application. There are different questions. So, it has nothing to do with the closed book. But if you complete this, that means you have read through once. In a way, it will help closed book exam. But it has no link with directly closed book exam.
Thank you so much. Sorry.
One more question I had. If we have any doubts sometime during the week as we prepare and all that, so can we get some time to interact, to ask those questions and clarify?
We can set up some time. And during that time, you can call us. We can try to answer.
Sure. We can fix time and have it. Yeah, that'll be great.
Yes. Okay. So thank you very much, everybody, for joining this orientation program. It is good participation. And there's good participation. Around we had 40 devotees, 35-40 devotees. So we hope to see all of you for this Bhakti Shastri course. And if you have any concerns, you can please contact us. We'll be happy to answer. And see you next week. So we'll be beginning the course next Sunday, 1 p.m. Okay, so we'll work out on the infrastructure, Zoom and everything, and we'll send you the final credentials. And our team will also work on making the groups and make all the structure, and then we'll launch the course. So try to register before 15th. Okay? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Bhakti Shastri Krishna.
Jai.
Somebody is asking.
Hare Krishna. Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat Hare Krishna. Okay.
Hare Krishna. Dandavat Pranam.